Everyone, Wasit here, back at action for more Comrade attraction. That's right, we're finally in Comrade, baby. Comrade never changes, does it? Yeah, like war. Suffice to say, we're near the end game now, baby. It feels wild to say that. Hey, sir, you must have a million memories here, huh? You could say that. Suppose it couldn't hurt to stop by some places while we gear up. And that's exactly what we do. Literally the first thing, right here. The Tenkaichi Street Gate. You could say it's a symbol of the city. Every time I pass through this gate, I get this feeling. I'm either heading off or coming back from a difficult battle. Maybe because this gate's always been there for every major occurrence of my life.
That's nostalgic.
Next time I pass through this gate, I wonder what kind of battle awaits me. Immediately. First thing there. Woo-wee! Let's see here. What do we have here? There's plenty of remittance stuff that we should, like, go off to go do. Which I will be glad to do so. Seem like there's a whole lot of other things, though. No bonding, no nothing. By essence, it doesn't really feel like it's, shall we say, a big area. The Cosmo family office used to be here. It's been a while since I passed through, though. Shintaro Kazuma. Only man I ever called Pops. He seemed so mature and unfathomable back then. Now, before I even knew it, I'm the same age as he was. Wonder, if I was a role model for someone, just like I was for me?
Ah, that takes me back.
No, that dream is long past. How's it going? I feel like you've been it to more people than Kazuma has ever been. Yeah, what of it?
I'm ready.
What of it, punk man?
I'm on a roll.
Oh my god, it actually has the whole thing too. Let's see here. There should be one, this one right here. There we go. That will get everybody. Oh, does it not do the thing? It doesn't do the thing like it does with the other stuff. That's a little bit sad. It gets the whole area, we might as well. Get you? Yeah, we're doing like a solid, like a huge amount of damage to all of them.
You're going to regret this.
And it went right through there, jeez. Damn, that booty. It's coming at you.
I won't hold back.
Should probably also, like, look on my equipment because I did change quite a few people.
Did you really think you'd win?
Let's go do that.
We should relish this moment.
Hardly a fair fight.
Alright, so. Let's go to Garir. Whoop, 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 whoop. That's fine. That's fine. Fine. Is there nothing for her? I'm pretty sure we have it. Piece item. There we go. Job experience. Yeah, that's fine. Alright, cool.
Okay.
Yeah, we're kind of just gonna like walk on through and just get whatever we're gonna get. Cause that's how it works. Boo boo. We're being a lot behind Serena. Nothing much to it. Except for some reason, I always end up in a fight here. From one-on-one scuffles to all-out battle royales. Here of all places. It is just an ideal place for a brawl.
I remember this.
Like some kind of punk rite of passage. gonna go out without throwing down at this arena of Backlund at least once. Heck yeah. Go over here. Plenty of other things. Eventually we'll be able to choose our own adventure. Serena. Or rather, New Serena. The only place in the city I feel the calmest. Nowadays, Dr. Sen and the Mama manage the place. But in the past, Anna was the Mama and Yumi worked here too. Nishiki and I frequented the place, even though we had no money. Back then, we just listened to each other ramble on and on. I thought those peaceful days would last forever. But now, I'm the only one left behind. Aw, Kiri, we can't just say it like that! That's so sad! I don't think I could ever get used to this loneliness.
This brings back memories.
It'd be nice if I could just walk into Serena, no hesitation, and have a drink. My boy's going through it. I'm gonna lead you to my poor boy. Been a while, Stardust. At one point, it was taken over by the Junwei Mafia. But it looks like Kazuki and Yuya, the owner and manager, put in a great deal of effort to reclaim its title as Kamurocho's top host club. This town's a harsh place for honest folk. They've earned my respect for not only surviving, but thriving here. Actually, that reminds me. First time I met Yuya, he came swinging at me right out of the blue. Said afterward that he mistook me for another Yakuza trying to squeeze protection money from them. Perhaps it's because they got spirit. They've all been able to make it out here. Kazuya, Yuya, this might be a tall order, but don't settle for being the best in Kamurocho. Aim to be the best in Japan.
Feels
and if
like
I'm
just
still
yesterday.
Alive by then, I'll send you two an extra large congratulatory wreath. Anonymously, I think. He loves the people here so much. They're like, they were here for me, and I want to be there for them. He's just like, ah, oh, Kiri, you big ol' softos. Nothing over that way. But it does seem like there is a reminiscence over here. Is that?
I can't breathe.
Hey, what's the matter? Are you all right?
Mimic event. I can't breathe.
Got it. Just hold on. Don't move.
No. Stop. Don't call an ambulance. I can't afford it.
This isn't the time for that. You could die.
Even if I survived this, I'd just be assumed dead if those thieving debt collectors come after me.
Damn it. Then what should I do? If he's refusing an ambulance, how can I help him? Should I look for a hospital nearby?
Stop and think. Yeah, let's look for one.
What are the chances of finding a hospital in the heart of Kamurocho? Wait a minute. Aren't we right near?
Yeah, you are. Oh, coffee shop, of course.
That's right. Emoto Medical Clinic. Home to Kamurocho's best physician. He'll treat this guy for free.
Some things never change.
It's been ages since we first met. Wouldn't matter if all of society turned its back on you. Doc Emoto doesn't refuse anyone in need. I respect the man. Good to know he's still kicking. Hang in there, all right? I'm gonna get you to a doctor.
Are we taking him or what? Well, let's get this at least. Pure steel. Considering how urgent this is, the man is dying of heart attack. Or maybe just gas. It might just be gas.
Doc, sorry to barge in. It's an emergency. Where is Dr. Emoto?
I'm Dr. Emoto, but if you're looking for my father, he's out currently. I'm sure he'll be back soon.
You took over the family business?
You must be.
But didn't you just say there's an emergency? Well, let's not waste time chatting. What's the situation? Can a patient move on his own?
A homeless man collapsed. He's having some sort of attack. He's on the street right now and won't take an ambulance.
Understood. This kind of thing is fairly typical. My apologies, but I'll need your help carrying him in.
Is he all right now?
Yes, he's fine. He's actually one of my father's patients. This tends to happen from time to time. Though, this time around, it was your intervention that ended up saving him.
That's a relief. So how is the old doctor these days?
Well, the years have taken their toll. In fact, that's more noticeable lately. Were you a patient of my father's?
No, I'm not exactly.
Huh? What's going on here? He injured?
All the time has not been well to him.
Attack. Seems he ran out of the meds you prescribed. That gentleman over there made me aware of the situation, so we were able to prevent a disaster.
Oh, I see. Thank you. And I'm sure he'd like to personally extend his thanks when he comes to.
No, there's no need for that. I've got to head out soon.
Earlier, it sounded as though you knew my father personally.
Well, I've heard a few things here and there, but it was quite a while ago.
Did you hear good things or bad things?
All good things.
Well, I suppose I should thank my lucky stars.
So, you run this clinic with your daughter now?
Hell no. This is my clinic. She's just a busybody who barges in whenever she feels like it. Taking after me was 100% her idea.
True, I was never asked, but someone has to keep this place running. No matter what my dad says.
Hell yeah.
I've told him he can retire anytime, but he absolutely refuses to settle down.
We love an ambitious daughter.
What's wrong?
No, my apologies. For a second, I mistook you for someone I knew way back when. Come to think of it, I heard he died a few years ago. He was a legend among the Yakuza here in Kamurocho.
You don't say.
That voice. You even sound just like him. But I guess that's downright impossible. To think, I almost accused a friend of faking his own death all those years ago. Preposterous.
Yeah. Unfortunately, you've got the wrong guy. I'm just passing through.
Right.
But I did haunt Kamurocho often in the past. I've heard a lot about you. In a town that only cares about money and women, there's a doctor who'll help anybody in need. A man of great character.
Well, that's pretty exaggerated. But it's nice to know that I'm a trusted physician.
What's with this heavy atmosphere? You two can just tell me if I'm in the way.
Oh, that's not it.
I'm going on break. You guys, take your time.
It must be reassuring to know you have a reliable successor. She grew up following in your footsteps. One look at her, and you can tell how strong-willed she is.
Isn't that the truth? Once my daughter makes up her mind, it's her way or the highway. But that's the right attitude to have when running a clinic like this. And patients seem to prefer being treated by her rather than an old grouch like me.
Well, yeah, of course. Pretty lady. Hello.
These days, all anyone ever seems to ask me is when I'm gonna retire.
That's a shame.
Damn straight. It only gets me even more fired up. At this rate, I'll be a doctor until my dying day.
Sounds like it.
Those ungrateful patients can't get rid of me yet.
It was good to see you, Dakimoto.
As someone who treats the injured and infirm, I can't exactly ask you to come again soon. But I'm here for you.
That's a really
Even if
sentiment.
You're guarding secrets, you can trust me. Doctor-patient confidentiality, you know.
Hell yeah.
Thanks. I might just take you up on that offer. Times have changed, and even the Tojo clan is long gone. But some things never change.
Like war!
Looks like I'm still no match for you, Dakimoto.
That was pretty sweet. We're really getting like tie-ins of various things that were just not like even close to like this is a rememberable character. This is just someone in Kiryu's life more so. Which I really like.
Light as a feather.
Stiff as a wind. I guess we're just gonna keep going. It's gonna be a moment. Pretty! That's pretty character design right there. Honestly, sometimes like I look at the things that like Yakuza have, and I'm like, why isn't this like actually real, Sega? Like, please, could you? She looks so cute. Why? She can't just be here. That's rude. That's rude as heck. Also, hi. Hello. What up, cutie? Shoot. You can't just give this to me. Oh my goodness.
Let's keep going.
Oh. You make me just like go wild here. Over there. Fair enough. What the hell is this? Like a party thing going on? They're like some guys? Comer Show Festival. Alright, whatever.
Give me a smile.
What have we got here? They really cleaned up this area. There used to be a lot of homeless camping here and there. And now they're nowhere to be seen. But that's the reason Comer Show has been thriving recently.
That's nostalgic.
So, personally, I didn't mind the old Comer Show that didn't bother giving up appearances and hiding its uglier sides. Yeah, honestly. Alright, what is over here? Just a little booth? Alright. A little bit sad that we just have a little booth there. We don't have it otherwise. Whatever. Oh, we're gonna get pocket racing? Let's go pocket racing! I need to be reminisced on that situation. I need to see Kiryu get all teary-eyed about, like, his pockets and pockets. Around here? Oh.
Hey! Pocket circuit racing!
Hey, let's go!
Neat! Let's go! Let's go! Yeah! I'll race you to the pocket circuit stadium!
Wait, it's back over here?
Really? Pocket Circuit Stadium. Kamurocho actually has one again.
Yeah! Did he make one? Friendship has no finish line. Heck yeah!
Ah, Pocket Circuit. Those little radio-controlled race cars. It's a surprisingly deep hobby, competing against others on elaborate racetracks. There was a time I was the fastest Pocket Circuit racer in Kamurocho, taking on all comers. I got to know the kids who frequented the place through racing and modding our cars together.
Oh my god.
And I even formed a lasting friendship with a Pocket Circuit fighter that managed our location. Last time I saw him was back in Onomichi. Hope he's doing all right.
God, I hope so too.
Stop being so annoying. Let me play how I want, fighter.
Hmm?
Oh? Is that
but
fighter?
That customization you put together won't work, Kojiro-kun. Try these tires instead. They'll give you more friction on turns. Come on, use them just once, buddy. For me?
Knock it off!
Is that
the tires
the
I
sun?
Have are the best. They're purple.
Purple's cool, but the color doesn't make it race better. Don't you want to stay on the track?
No, shut up already! Fighter, you suck!
Let's
All
go find
mean.
Something to do at the park.
Yeah, this is dumb, Yasukun.
Aw, just give it a little more time. It's fun. Not again. Jeez, I can't get these kids to listen.
Right? That outfit. He must be the new Pocket Circuit Fighter. Feels like he's having some trouble.
Oh well. Better clean up. Whoa!
Oh?
Ooh! Sorry about that.
Huh. A golem tiger.
Oh? You recognize it?
Of course he does.
I used to race here, actually. Back with the first Pocket Circuit Fighter.
Whoa. So, my name's Muranaka. I'm a new fighter, employed by the Pocket Circuit Company themselves.
Well, as far as Pocket Circuit goes, I'm Kazuma.
Hell yeah.
Kazuma-kun, huh? Pleasure to meet you. So if you knew this branch's first fighter, you must go back a while.
I started in the bubble era. Must have been 30 years ago now.
Whoa, that would have been the first boom period. Amazing. I'd have loved to have been there to see it. Is it true how popular it was back then?
I'd say so. From what I recall, it really swept the country for a time. Then one day, the Kamurocho Stadium was gone. I'm surprised to see it come back now.
Ah, yeah, it did die down for a while, but recently there's been a surge of interest. The market's swelling again. On top of that, we have a new company president. He's a Pocket Circuit fanatic, apparently. I'm super into it. He came up with a bunch of innovative new mixed media strategies to get younger school kids back into RC racing.
That sounds effective.
The hell is mixed media?
So, what made you want to be a Pocket Circuit fighter?
Everything else aside? The cars. Pocket Circuit cars fascinate me. Pocket Circuit's popularity was waning by the time I got into it, but I didn't care. I'd spend every afternoon customizing my rig. All of my meager allowance went toward building the best machine I could. I didn't have friends at school, but eventually, I met people through Pocket Circuit. It was like finding my place in the world. Oh, it was so much fun in those days.
I get it. That made you want to become a fighter.
Yep. It was the fighter at my local branch who approached me when he saw that I would race alone. He helped bring me together with the other kids. I finally made friends. All thanks to him. That's the person I want to be. Someone who can help cheer kids up when they're going through hard times. That's a true Pocket Circuit fighter.
I think that's the right idea. You're a good fit.
Except, this job's a lot harder than I thought it'd be. When it comes to Pocket Circuit tech, nobody knows more than me. And I just want to pass on that knowledge. Teach kids the best customizations. Support their curiosity. But when I try, oh, I can't get through to them. The kids all seem to hate me. Maybe I'm just not cut out to be a fighter.
Oof.
Now that I'm 30, it might be time to move back home.
Oh, dang.
Are you laughing at me?
No. It's just that back in my day, the fighter here was in a very similar position.
Heck yeah.
He and I raced together a lot. I have nothing but good memories of him. It's been a long time, but I still consider him a close friend.
You really had that kind of bond?
He was a great spokesperson for the hobby, and good with kids. Still, he had his share of troubles. The company never saw him as more than a disposable part-timer. When he had 30, he had a hard time staying with it.
Wow. What did he do?
He decided to remain a fighter. He loved Pocket Circuit. The kids loved him. In the end, he couldn't turn away from that love.
The kids loved him, huh? Makes me jealous. If I only had a better relationship with them, I wouldn't be so conflicted.
Let me ask, what do you imagine the kids there want from you?
Me? Well, I'm the Pocket Circuit fighter. They want me to teach them the best way to race, don't they?
That's an important part of it. The fighter should be someone you can consult on builds. However, do you really think that's what children are looking for?
Exactly.
Huh?
You told me about the fighter who helped you as a kid, but you didn't mention his technical expertise. Did you decide to become a fighter because he made you a faster car? Did you idolize him because he taught you which tire set takes sharp turns better?
Of course not. He meant the world to me because when I had nobody, he rescued me from my loneliness.
Oh! Just picture this for a second. See this for a second. Kiryu does not have a lot of friends. And the fact that in 6, he meets one of his dearest friends, the Pocket Circuit Fighter. This brings new context to the whole entire, like, Kiryu, like, always, like, needs somebody with him to, like, just kind of, like, be there in support of him, because he does have that loneliness in him. And, like, there's plenty of people that have been there for him in a way that, like, he doesn't really see. And I think Pocket Circuit Fighter right there is really nice in a sentimental sort of way. Because, like, Kiryu didn't have that either. So that's just really sweet, actually.
I think you understand now. What is it the children want from their fighter? You know the answer, don't you?
Wind.
Kazuma-kun. You're right. This whole time, I've been mistaken. Pocket Circuit might be a technical hobby, but that's not its heart. It can't be only about winning and losing. First and foremost, it's about having fun with your fellow racers.
Mm-hmm.
I can't believe I looked past something so obvious. Ugh, no wonder the kids hate me.
It's not too late, you know.
Right. I'm gonna find those kids. This time, I won't talk about wheels. I'll talk about feels. Pocket Circuit runs on love.
Oh.
Good. I'm sure they'll take to that lesson.
Oh, thanks so much, Kazuma-kun. Fighter away!
Vroom! Those kids are probably in Public Park 3. I'm gonna go check on them. Yeah, maybe, but we'll leave it at that for now. There looks like there's another one over here. Yes. Good old sewer. Children's Park. Nothing unusual about this park, except for the manhole in the back. Underneath is an intricate sewer system. Some might say it's just another facade of the city. At one point, Akiyama went into hiding here.
I remember this.
To be honest, it seemed kind of fun. Maybe I should experience it myself once before I move on to the next life. I don't know why I gotta be so morbid with that, Kiryu, but okay. There's nothing in here? Alright, fair enough. What else we got over here? There's so many little things.
Light as a bell.
Well, let's look. There's the building there. Now it's a Club Green Rose? Not what I remember it being. This is a bench, but it's probably about this place. The Yoshida Batting Center. I went to the batting cages with Sonhi and the others in Yokohama. But nowhere else can top this place. I felt like working up a sweat.
Feels like just yesterday.
Sense of balls flying for old time's sake. Get every curve ball out of the park. I'll be leveled up. Let's go. Let's go inside. There's probably some other things here. No? I guess not. Aha! That was a good hit. Baseball bats reminds me of Majima-san. I wonder if the other Tojo clan officers think so too. Goro Majima, a reckless man, one who lives by his own rules. Can't tell you how many times he's tried to kill me, but at the same time, can't even count how many times he saved my life. He's one messed up guy. But despite all that, he's more suited to be a boss than I ever was.
Ah, that takes
me back. If both Majima-san and Kazuga could lend me a hand, I feel like I could take on the world. Oh! He still loves his Aniki. Let's go. I think he's only called like Majima Aniki, I think, three times total in this entire series. It's kind of insane when you think about it. Ooh, look at this. What's this reminiscent of? Still a satisfying sound. Whenever I think of baseball, Shinida comes to mind. Him? Hasuo Shinida, a man who once made his debut in the major of big leagues. Felt victim to a fate so cruel, it'd be wrong to write it off as bad luck. But despite everything, never lost his passion for baseball. I don't think I'm capable of dedicating my entire life to one thing like he was. I respect him for that, and envy him a little too. Though, it's never too late to start trying, is it?
That's nostalgic.
Maybe I still have time to find my true passion. Like what baseball is to Shinada. We're getting good. For sure.
Whoa!
Yeah, that fell hard. That is like such a special animation that does not get played very often.
Should I open it?
Yes, of course.
Nice.
Insolence. Whatever.
This is
we got a love hotel. Getting around here hasn't changed a bit. Just remembered something hilarious. About 10 years ago, I had encountered with Shima Bokuro, captain of the small Okinawa Yakuza family. One time we had to pretend to be a couple to sneak into a love hotel. Caught me off guard. At the time, I couldn't believe what was happening. But looking back now, it was pretty funny. Yeah.
Feels like just thank yesterday.
You for that. Yeah. Isn't that the dude that, like, kind of bit it? I swear, Aziz, that was the case. Looks like there's one more over here. Let's go looking. Oh. Yeah, it looks like Kamurocho is getting genderfied. I have a feeling that this is gonna come up real soon. The genderfication in the next Yakuza game, I could definitely see it. Also, hello, everybody. Why?
I'm on a roll. Let's go.
Well, first things first. Let's aim over here. I swear it did something else other than that. My defense is lower. Oh my god. Tag team? Interesting. Wow, there's a lot more people than I thought. That works.
Right. Special order.
Enjoy.
Now then, you do something.
Hey, then we tag team.
Counting on
sure.
You, Yusan.
Yeah.
Bring the noise.
Ready when you are.
Okay,
right, everyone. Let's go.
Thanks.
All good. Such a big deal.
Follow my lead.
All right. Time to bust this nut.
Time to put you down.
I did not get to do enough. A little bit sad by that. There's so many of them though.
What's the holdup?
There's the grapple. Let's try it. How the heck had up? Oh jeez! Oh no! That was close. Okay. So far, it's good. Double time, baby. Okay, we're almost down. What we got here? Dragon Ascension. What in the area. A little bit up, my dude. We got one! That's good! Getting one is good. Let's go ahead. Oh, we can call them both here.
You want some?
Wait, can we just straight up call her? Sure.
Delivery.
Yo? Oh, so it's a summon. Yeah! She looks so good! He's a crack. That's what Hunk gets for being in a game other than Resident Evil 4. How dare you? She just kept going. Damn, dude.
Follow my lead.
Okay. Tiger Palm Strike. Ready for sure, why not? What are you doing? Laser beams! Why does he have laser beams?
I feel so heavy.
Okay.
You can win. In for the
yeah,
kill.
Let's just try that.
I doubt you'll need to.
Here you go.
I do something.
Let's get make him fold. Good, good. Electricity bad for you now. Let's try to get him cold. Yeah, that's what I thought, bud. Boy! Boy. Too rough, no too rough! Sure, burning arrow will work.
Pretty bold.
Did you really
doing better than I thought.
There's more where this came
strong.
From.
All right, what were they hiding? Armature Hills. It's practically as big as a Millennial Tower. Back when this place was still under construction, I fought to the death of a man on the very same rooftop. Ryuji Koda, the Dragon of Kansai. He was powerful. More so than anyone I've ever faced before. I go as far as to say the man was a monster. That's why I sometimes get this feeling that he'll suddenly reappear right before my eyes. But no.
Ah, that takes me back.
I wonder if the kids of Morning Glory feel the same way about me. Well then. Oh my god, Zal's like so close to death though. With that being said, we're kind of just going to go right back down and hit this little spot we need to go visit for our next trip. Until then, though, we still have plenty of Kamurocho to explore. And I shall see you all next time when we do that. Until then, sayonara! Bye-bye!